In the early 2000s, Dr. Simon Goodman was working as a research fellow at the Zoological Society of London when he was approached by Dr. Birna Cedeño from the biotechnology and social enterprise organization Concepto Azul in Ecuador. Birna invited Simon to collaborate on a project to investigate invasive diseases and their impact on endemic species in the Galapagos. The aim was to help protect the native biodiversity of the wildlife of the Galapagos Islands by establishing a new molecular biology laboratory on the islands, staffed by Ecuadorian scientists to support disease testing in situ, rather than having to rely on external researchers. Disease threats to Galapagos birds from introduced parasites and diseases were highlighted in 2000 following a workshop at Cornell University. However, at the time, a lack of information about potential introduction routes for invasive pathogens into the Galapagos ecosystem made it difficult for the Ecuadorian authorities to develop appropriate biosecurity strategies. In 2004, Simon, now at the University of Leeds, together with his ZSL colleague, Prof. Andrew Cunningham and Birna, used funding from the UK government's Darwin Initiative grant scheme to create the Galapagos Genetics, Epidemiology and Pathology Lab. This was a cross-disciplinary collaboration, also involving the Galapagos National Park Service and the University of Guayaquil, designed to increase local capacity for wildlife disease research, investigations and surveillance. Simon, Andrew and Birna's team undertook varied investigations into native and potentially invasive diseases which could pose a threat to the unique species of the Galapagos, such as giant tortoises, sea lions, and many of the endemic bird species found there, since the native species would have limited immunity to novel pathogens. The research was carried out in three stages. Firstly, collaborating with Professor Marm Kilpatrick of the University of California, Santa Cruz, they carried out risk assessments to identify potential introduction routes for diseases of particular concern, such as the mosquito-transmitted West Nile virus, which had recently caused mass mortalities of bird species in North America. The assessment identified transport of mosquitoes via aircraft and boat traffic, supporting the tourist industry, as being particularly important. From this, they developed a new biosecurity policy and implementation plan to help reduce the risks from these human activities. The second stage of the research involved conducting a genetic study of Galapagos mosquitoes, which confirmed that some mosquitoes were being transported by aircraft from the continent and moved around the islands by boats on an ongoing basis, validating the original conclusions from the risk assessment. Thirdly, working with vector-borne disease ecologist Laura Kramer in the United States, they showed that the Galapagos mosquitoes could indeed transmit West Nile virus, highlighting the importance of implementing the new biosecurity measures to prevent the disease arriving to the islands. The team's partners in Ecuador were able to lobby the Ecuadorian government to change national legislation and implement the recommended biosecurity measures, including chemical disinfection treatment on aircraft and changing aircraft routing to stop direct international flights to the islands. Subsequently, the Ecuadorian government invested in creation of a new agency, ABG, with a remit to protect the biosecurity of the Galapagos. This transfer from research to impact via policy change has led to continuing strategic developments for managing biosecurity on all cargo entering the Galapagos Islands. Now, new research by team members is underway into other vector-borne diseases such as avian malaria, which could also threaten Galapagos bird species.